Thursday morning, P.O. We don't have any callers today, so I'll bring up one of my own pet peeves.
P.O. positive or pet peeve?
The idiotic plans for pedestrianization of Main Street. It's... Well, don't get me started or I won't even have time for the weather. Speaking of, a few clouds early on, but they will be gone soon. Music time!
Here's your mail. It's heavier than I thought. All right, I'll leave it on the doorstep. Interesting. Mm-hmm.
Yes, yes, yes. He could only look on in sheer terror as Madeline threw the key straight into the lake. Oh, yes. This is good stuff.
Excuse me, sir?
Oh, for Christ's sakes, go away! If I've told you once, I've told you 1,000 times!
You must have me confused with someone else, sir.
Oh, bloody heck, do I sound like I care? You lot are all the same to me. Just go away! How many yokels are there in this backwater town? Do they realize people come out to these kinds of places because they're supposed to be remote and quiet?
Do you know the Postal Service motto? Neither snow, nor rain, nor heat, nor gloom of night, so on and so forth. But no one ever added neither rudeness, nor arrogance, nor insults, last I checked.
I do beg your pardon. Yes, I am expecting a package. I didn't know you were from the Postal Service, ma'am.
Should it even matter who I am? Shouting at random strangers is generally considered rude.
All right, I'm sorry. It's just, I've been under a lot of pressure lately from my publisher, as well as my wife. I do appreciate your driving all the way up here, and Lord knows I'll be needing those ribbons. Just please leave them on the porch, and thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
All right. Now, where was I? She threw the key in the lake. Then what happens? Oh, Christ's sake, she made me lose my bloody train of thought. No, wait, I got it. And then he says...
I didn't bring the package.
Meredith! Look at this house on wheels! I have no idea where it came from, but it's absolutely rad.
It's mine, actually. Mickey and June gave it to me. You know, that young couple down by the lake campground.
Whoa, really? That's so tight! Here, they left this note on the driver's seat.
Oh, let me read it. Life's a journey and not a destination. Just grab the wheel and enjoy the ride. Love, M&J.
So, what are you going to do with it? You have to hit the road.
I don't know what I want yet. I was hoping it could stay here for a while. You can tinker on it, too.
You know I'd love tinkering, but it's going to need a lot of work. It can stay here for as long as you need.
Good to hear, Lori. I can already hear the cogs in your head spinning at top speed. What are your plans?
Well, if it's going to be here a while, I should give it a name first. Can't have such a beautiful vehicle and not give it a name. How about the Sea Turtle? Big, slow, washed up, just like a turtle, or the raccoon, because it's got brown spots and is full of trash, or the hermit shell. It had many owners over the years, just like the shell of a hermit crab.
I like the sea turtle.
Good choice. I'll get working on it right away. See you later.
Bye.
Thank you. dear, you're a sight for sore eyes.
Oh, hi, Miss J... Mildred? How so? Is something wrong with the cats again?
It's just... this week, it's all a bit much for me. I need to get my hair done for Sunday's special evening, but I can't leave my cats alone. And then all of a sudden, Frank has gone missing. He still needs to bring me an envelope. Please tell me that you have it with you.
I'm afraid this is just a postcard. But what do you mean he needs to bring you an envelope?
Oh, don't be a nosy posy, Meredith. Oh dear, he can't just have vanished into thin air, can he?
Don't worry, I'm sure Frank will show up again.
Oh, Frankie boy, always making me worry too much. And I need to cancel the hairdresser's appointment, but what if I can't reschedule?
Perhaps I could look after your cats.
Would you, my dear? It's tomorrow evening. That would be such a relief for me. And the cats.
Tomorrow night? Sure, no trouble at all.
Oh, thank you so much, dear. Just show up at 7 and eat as many cookies as you like.
Good afternoon, Miss Weiss.
Good afternoon, Mr. Morgan.
I wanted to let you know that today was my last day here.
I see. Well, thanks for the help. Where are you going now?
That's all I have to say. Good luck.
Hello?
Hi, Em. It's me, Kay.
Oh, hi, Kay.
Good. You're home. Listen, I don't know if you're busy tonight, and I wouldn't normally bother you like this, but I'm kind of in a huge pickle at the moment, and now I'm imagining being inside of a huge pickle. Thanks, brain.
Sure. What's up?
Okay, so this is going to sound like I'm 16, but I have these tickets to a really big concert tonight for Barry and me, and it seems the babysitter has just bailed on me. All right, so maybe the babysitter part doesn't sound like I'm 16, I hope. Anyway, it's Journey, so I'm like, I need to go tonight, and I got these tickets ages ago. And it's a long drive to Portland, so we'll probably be out all night. And I promise you, I've called everyone and their brother. Besides, they're really good kids to watch tonight.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Can I get a shortcut to the question?
Yeah, sorry. You're totally right. I'm blabbering on R&I. Okay, don't freak out. You got this. All right, recap. Journey tonight, in Portland, got tickets, sitter bailed. So I guess you figured out by now that I'm awkwardly trying to ask if maybe you could do me a huge favor and watch Grace and Max tonight?
Hey, it's fine. Don't worry. I'll babysit tonight.
Oh my god, you serious? That would help me out in such a big way! And I would owe you big time. Huge!
No problem. So, what time do you need me?
You're a lifesaver. As soon as you can make it. You don't have to bring anything. There's food, videos, even a cardboard replica of Apollo 11 with a set of matching helmets. You're covered. See you in a bit!
All right! See ya! All right. Who wants s'mores?
Hey, guess who's back?
Frank? I'm so glad to see you again.
I'm so happy to be here again. I guess Morgan didn't stick around to welcome me back.
I guess I can't blame him.
Oh well, he'll never get his way here.
What happened the last few days?
Well, what can I say? Don't mess with the big boys. I guess they didn't understand that some of my customers do a little more than talking about their cats.
Ooh, this sounds very juicy.
Frank Coleman's no stranger to the high-stakes game. I've got lawyers in my inner circle. All it took were a couple of lawsuit threats.
Sweet. That should keep him off our backs for a while.
Haha, yes. But that buffoon will be back. You can bet on it.
What odds can you give me?
Haha, Meredith. I better get back to work.
A very good morning, Providence Oaks.
Theo, positive report. That's key.
I wonder what it'll be today. Actually, no. Nancy, the floor is yours.
Yeah, Jack, I've got a pet peeve. Why do people start stink coughing when I'm smoking in my store? If you don't like it, just leave.
Thank you much, Nancy. And, well, if you're asking, it's not like people have other places to go besides the smokehouse that you call a general store. On to the weather forecast. Sunny in the first half of the day and some clouds in the second. Back to the playlist.
That's lighter than I thought.
Driving along the highway,
hello? Friday delivery day.
Well, just call me Friday Delivery K. Okay, no, that sounded better in my head.
Someone's in a good mood today.
Yes, thanks for looking after Max and Gracie last night. You were a real trooper for stepping in last minute.
Are they okay? Did they mention anything?
Max did say I owe him pancake breakfast for the rest of the week, and Grace said she will never sleep again, but yeah, pretty much. What movie did you watch with them anyway?
So, how was the concert?
Oh yeah, man, Journey is so good. Those songs have been stuck in my head all day.
That sounds great.
I know, right? There's just so much cool stuff being created right now, you know? I mean, Journey was cool. I got to know them through Barry at first, but I tell you, if Prince or New Order ever came to Portland, I would sell my spleen for tickets.
One spleen, two bands. That's quite the potential dilemma.
Oh, and I haven't even mentioned Cyndi Lauper or Run DMC. Or Stevie Wonder. And before you go there, I know you're probably setting up a joke about spleens and Hammond organs right now.
I would never.
All jokes aside, though, I spent half the concert thinking about how I haven't really focused on my own music for a while now. Kids, work, all that stuff. So much going on. And I mean, I love tinkering, but right now, I'm not sure I'm even creating anything cool or just... You know, not even Barry is allowed to listen to my songs at this stage, to be honest.
I'd love to hear your music sometime. I'm sure it's great.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. Maybe I'll hold you to that. I was thinking, I have a mixtape with some of my stuff, you know? Just something I've been trying out with my new synthesizer.
I'd be honored.
That's great. It's just something I've been playing around with Don't expect any fireworks. And hey, don't tell me what you think yet, yeah? You'll be my secret special audience of one, so I can get used to the idea of an audience.
Any special reason?
Ong, new synth this Sunday. Holy crap, I just said that out loud! Dude! You are coming to the open mic, right?
Of course! That's great! Wild horses couldn't drag me away.
But act cool, yeah? No one else knows yet. See you there.
Sure thing. Back to my own journey, for now. Haha.
Nope, ignoring that. Bye now.
Interesting.
Ah, the waxworms have arrived.
Excuse me?
I meant the package, Miss Weiss. It's my worms. For fishing. They're just in time. I'm taking a boat to the island this afternoon.
Oh, nice. A boat trip.
Hey, you can tag along if you want, like your father used to. But I'm not helping you with any waxworms.
Oh, really? Sounds like fun.
Okay, we'll show up here at 4 p.m. sharp.
Here's your mail. Robert.
How are you? I was away for a few days, on an urgent job out of state.
I'm good. It's nice to see you again. Here's the mail.
Thanks, and likewise. Priority mail from Town Hall. Let's see what they have to say this time. Dear Mr. Harris, on behalf of yada yada yada, concerning Environmental Management Act 1213, yada yada yada. Wait. What? Listen to this. We have decided to postpone the construction of apartments for at least 6 months. We hope this satisfies you, as well as the many residents of Providence Oaks that contacted us with their unfiltered and enthusiastic comments. It worked! The plan worked!
Wow, great! So happy for you, Robert.
We need to celebrate this. How about tomorrow night? Steak dinner at Moe's, or something else, on me.
Oh, I'd love that.
Great. It's gonna be fun. See you tomorrow night, then. Gotta go now. The telephone troops need to know the assault can be abandoned.
Thank you.
I'm calling it a day. So, is this a quiet day, or does it always take this long?
Fishing requires patience. We've only been here for 2 hours.
And that's the nice thing about fishing.
Well, there's a fine line between boredom and relaxation.
I find it hard to relax sometimes.
Fishing also requires silence.
Bert, can I ask you a question? Do you like Maureen?
We ought to be heading back home. It's been a fine day, and I thank you for the company.
Kay's tape. Let's have a listen.
Okay.
Driving along the highway, headlights light up the signs, thinking of what might have been. Radio keeps track of time.
Hello?
Hi, Meredith. Guess what I signed today?
The contracts for the Adit 87 deal?
Oh, yes. You are now talking to Steve Mitchell, CEO of a multi-million dollar enterprise. But before I continue my insufferable bragging, I have a thing or two to say to you, about you. You've been a huge part of the success of this company, and I feel this is just the beginning. We're entering the golden age of personal computers, and we've got front row tickets. The past 2 weeks have made me realize that I couldn't have done it without you, and I'm going to need you even more in the coming years. So, here's a new monster deal I want you to think about. Become a partner in the company for 20% of the shares and a significant pay raise. Significant. The only condition is that I need your commitment for the next 5 years. So, there it is. Think about it, and let's talk about it more when you're back in the office.
Oh, wow, Steve. That sounds great.
Just let it sink in a bit. I don't need an answer right now. I have to get back to my million-dollar lifestyle. Actually, no, I need to get cranking on lots of stuff. Talk soon, Meredith.
Good evening, feline friends. Aunt Meredith's gonna keep you company tonight.
Come here.
Kitty. Ow. A postcard? from Angie.
Miss Meredith, I am so, so sorry I haven't been able to see you. It's just that I've been swamped organizing my not-so-timely exit from Providence Oaks. I'm sure you understand. You've probably seen the foreclosure notice. That certainly helped expedite my decision to leave. Anyway, I'll be honest. I'm still thinking about that kiss we shared in the car. And I don't usually dwell on these kind of things. So, feel special, Meredith. I hear you're going to the open mic night on Sunday. I wasn't planning on going, but I want to see you before I leave. I'm really anxious to find out what you've decided to do. Whether you're going to stay in this town, or go back to the city, or do something else entirely. And I'm going to be forward, as you know I always am. I'd like to know if little old me figures into those plans, somehow. So, anyway, I'll see you there, yeah? Love, Angie.
Happy Saturday, everyone. It's time once again for a...
Theo, positive for that key.
Today's verdict is from Cheryl.
Hi, Jack. I went for a walk the other day and suddenly encountered a majestic stag. We looked at each other for a few seconds and then he walked off into the woods.
Wow, Cheryl. I'm glad you could retell the tale. Stags can be dangerous. Today's weather might be dangerous too. You'll need your raincoat all day long and there will be a thunderstorm tonight. Back to the music.
Here's your mail. I didn't bring the package. Oh, that's heavier than I thought.
Ah, you're still here, huh?
That makes two of us.
When are your parents coming back?
Actually, they might just stay in Florida.
Florida? Your parents?
Yeah, isn't it weird?
They'll be back soon. Florida is expensive and honestly isn't all it's cracked up to be.
We'll see what happens.
Sunshine and the beach get boring real fast.
Well, I better be on my way. Have a nice day.
Okay, fellow Providence Oakians, it's time once again for the sent in letters and announcements. This one's from our very own Maureen, or Mo as we all know
her. Hey folks, just wanted to grab your ears for a second to let you know all about the upcoming open mic night over at Mo's Diner this Sunday. That's right, claim your 15 minutes of fame, enjoy some swell performances, and the usual good food and drinks for everyone. I expect to see all of y'all for a great evening, and maybe even some dancing. You know who you are. Come join the show at Moe's at 8 p.m. this Sunday. I'll come get you if you don't.
Well, you heard her, folks, and I'll be there too, so you better not miss it. Back to the music and to one of my favorite songs. Mail Carrier Meredith.
Farmer DJ Jack.
Seen any ghost drivers on the way here?
Ghost drivers?
Yeah, you know, people driving on the wrong side of the road.
Nope, haven't seen them.
Okay, I was just wondering. Don't bother. I need to get back to the live show. See you tomorrow, I reckon. Bye now.
I reckon.
Oh, and please close the door. Don't want to broadcast any mail truck noise. Thank you much.
Thank you.
It's the mail.
I'm busy.
Aren't we all?
No! Damn it! I almost had it. I almost fucking had it. Thanks for breaking my concentration.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Video games are supposed to be fun. I feel horrible. Absolutely horrible.
I know the feeling.
You know what? I can beat this damn game, and I'm not quitting until I have.
Okay. Nope, no answer. Thank you.
so ends a week full of turmoil.
You can say that again.
If only the Angels hadn't lost to the White Sox. That would have made it perfect.
Never underestimate White Sox.
They're playing each other again tonight. Should I change the bet?
Nope. Hold the line.
Okay, let's see what happens. Maybe you're my lucky charm. Have a great weekend, Meredith. Oh, wait, this was your last day. I totally forgot to tell you, but they still haven't found someone else for the job. So, I guess, you can have it, if you want.
Wow. That sounds quite nice, actually.
Of course. And it's a great job. You know what? Think about it, and let me know Monday morning when you return your stuff. Gotta run now. Red Sox are playing the Yankees.
Hello?
Hi, Meredith. It's your dad again. How was your time in the mail delivery business?
Oh, hi, Dad. Well, I actually really loved it.
Awesome. Maybe you should just keep doing it. Worked out well for me.
Actually, it seems like they haven't filled the vacancy yet.
They haven't? Well, you know what I'd do. Oh, hold on, Meredith.
Let me guess. Mom wants to talk to me?
Hi, Meredith. Sorry to butt in, but you're thinking about staying in Providence Oaks?
Hi, Mom. Well, yeah, why not? I like it here.
Well, PO is wonderful, of course. I know. But you've got so much going on. Do you want to leave all that behind?
It's tricky. It's the thing with having the cake and eating it, too.
Is it just work-related, or are there other people involved? You know, any interesting ones, perhaps?
Well, there are some interesting developments, yes.
Oh, there are? But are they really interesting enough to give up your entire career? I really think you need to think long and hard on it. Oh, hold on.
I have a suspicion Dad wants to talk to me.
Meredith, I just wanted to say, you need to clean the lint filter on the dryer every once in a while. If you never do that, it could burn the house down.
No problem, Dad. I'll make sure to do that.
Great, thanks. I sometimes suddenly worry about things like that in the middle of the night. And it's not about the dryer, of course. I want you to be safe. And I'm sure you'll be okay.
I'll tell the dryer that he's on your mind.
Thanks. And could you also pet him on his back every now and then? He likes that. Oh, running out of coins. Gotta go. Bye, Em. Take care.
I hope you don't think I'm a cheapskate for having dinner here. There aren't a lot of other restaurants around, and I'm pretty sure their food isn't better than Moe's.
Don't worry about it, Robert. I love it here.
Thanks, Meredith. You're such a kind person.
Good evening, you two beautiful people. Ready to order?
Ladies first.
Hi, Maureen. It's hard to pass up a juicy T-bone steak.
Excellent choice, Meredith. And what would you like to wash it down with?
I think I'll have a beer.
Gotcha. Robert?
The usual for me, Maureen.
All right, Robert. T-bone steak and a beer. Doesn't get any more lumberjack than that. Be right back, folks. Ashley, get the steaks out!
Maureen's the best. Did you hear about the open mic night she's organizing?
Yeah, she only told me about it a dozen times.
I wish I could go, especially since I heard that Jack's gonna do a thing.
Jack? What's he gonna do? Announce the weather for next week?
Believe it or not, he's a very good ballet dancer.
Jack? Really?
No, he's into comedy. Would have loved to have heckled him. Oh well, this is a good week anyhow.
Must be nice that the apartments are off your mind for a while.
Alrighty, here are your beverages, folks. I'm afraid the food might take a little longer, as a certain kitchen helper thought the freezer was a good place for storing steaks. I really should get one of those microwave ovens to defrost them.
You seem a little stressed. Is it the upcoming open mic?
Why should I be stressed about that? It's going to be lovely. And you better be there, Robert Harris.
Maureen, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid I won't be able to make it.
I did not just hear you say that, young man. Oh, by the way, Meredith. I need to steal him for 2 minutes. He needs to check on some wiring for me.
Excuse me, Meredith. This is Maureen's jurisdiction. Have to obey the law. That tasted so good. Thanks, Maureen, for the fantastic blueberry pie.
You're welcome. It's my way of making up for stealing you away from Meredith. Ooh, I swear. She can give quite the stink eye if she wants, can't you, hon?
Ooh, boy. The world would be boring without her. Speaking of, are you going to miss your daily delivery round?
Yes, I probably will.
Must be nice here compared to the big city.
Have you always lived in a small town?
Yeah, Providence Oaks is my second one. After my divorce, I had to move away from the first one. Everything and everyone reminded me of her.
And how are you now? Have you gotten over it?
But maybe I shouldn't bother you with the innermost feelings of a lumberjack.
Wouldn't be a bother at all.
Robert and Meredith, sorry to break up your conversation, but we're closing up early tonight. Gotta set up some stuff for the open mic night, and I can't use any peeping eyes.
Oh, okay, Maureen. No problem.
Let me get the check for you, so I can leave you two to your lovely evening.
Can you put it on my tab, Maureen?
Anything for you, darling.
Do you mind if I pay? Or at least for half of it?
Meredith, after all your help, this is the least I can do. So, yes, I mind. Now let's get going before Maureen gets her broom out. Meredith, thanks again for your help. I'm not sure what would have happened if you hadn't come here for your mail delivery vacation.
It was nothing. Glad it got sorted out just in time.
Sure did. For now. Take care. Hope to see you around again.
You too, Robert. Take care. But you're not leaving without a hug.
Anyway, I love this town. You know I do. So, I'm dedicating my last jokes to specific people here tonight. The first one's for Maureen. A guy walks into a bar, and dozens of slabs of meat are hanging from the ceiling. So he asks the bartender, "What's up with the hanging meat up there, man?" So the bartender says, "Ah, you're new here. Well, we like to play a game here. If you can jump up and slap a steak, the house will pay for your drinks all night. However, if you miss, you have to pay everyone else's bar tab. So, want to give it a go?" "Nah," says the man. "Those stakes are too high." This one's for our own newcomer, Meredith Weiss. So, A woman's driving down the freeway. But all of a sudden, she hears a local news bulletin warning drivers on the very freeway she's on. They're saying, please be advised of this very dangerous situation of a car going the wrong way. So the woman says to herself, one car? Why, there's dozens!
Well, folks, wasn't that special? Now, let me know if any of you have any jokes about Jack, you hear? It's an open mic, after all. It's actually time for a little break right now. So come on up to the bar for some of our finest concessions. We'll continue shortly.
Mildred, how are you? And how are the cats?
Fine on both counts, dear. Thank you for asking. So, do you like the hair?
Looking fine as always.
Thank you, dear. Pity it's quite the waste of time and money, seeing as how I can't stay for long.
Really? What's the rush?
You see, my son decided to drop by, unannounced, and he's staying the whole weekend.
Oh, that's wonderful news.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, anyway, take care, dear. Now, where did he park the car?
Yes, it's me, Matt Kearney, in an egg brace. Real funny, huh?
Oh, hi, Matt. What happened?
Well, I was about to send the final boss to the afterlife, but then the computer crashed. I kicked my foot out in anger and fell from my chair, and now I'm here looking like a loser.
I'm sure you'll beat the game one day. Don't give up on the dream.
I can't play like this, but I'm going to work out a strategy in the meantime.
Guess who?
Jack Burton.
Aw, now I'm going to be a disappointment. It's just me.
Aw. That's a real bummer.
So, what have I missed?
Well, Matt Kearney's condition is worth a mention. But the final act is supposed to be the real showstopper. At least, that's what Maureen tells me.
Really? Well then, I guess I arrived just in time.
So, how've you been? Thanks for the note. It was very sweet.
I meant every word, babe. So, have you...
Hey, Meredith. Hey, Angie. Sorry to pop in like this, but I just wanted to inform you I fixed everything on the RV. She's got a new radio, I replaced some wiring, adjusted windshield wiper speed. The sea turtle is ready to go!
That's great, Lori. Thanks. I'm sure she's just like new.
Well, I wouldn't say that, but you'll see. Gotta go, later.
An RV? You never told me you had an RV.
Well, it's kind of a recent development. You know Mickey and June?
The hippie couple? Sure do.
They told me it was mine if I wanted it. And I did. Then Lori gave it a checkup. And now I am the proud owner of this sea turtle.
Wow, good for you. I'd love a free RV.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with it.
Cool. So, where are you going to take it?
Wherever the open road takes me.
Sounds good to me. A free spirit, the way Mickey and June intended. Can I come?
I have grown quite fond of you, you know.
Likewise, Miss Weiss. But at some point, you've got to give me a definite answer. You get that, right?
Look alive, folks! It's time for the final act. It's a doozy!
Saved by the bell, babe. I got stuff to do anyway.
Okay, I'll let you know.
Dear people, none other than our own Kate Evans will perform next. She has been writing songs since she was a little girl. And I cannot say how thrilled I am to host her first performance of hopefully many to come. I am so proud of you, honey. Please put your hands together for Kay, everyone.
Okay, here goes nothing. Drive on or go left, go right. Suddenly these choices make me smile. What if I just enjoy the ride? Life's a game of chance. For every break you get, you leave another one behind. Just as long as you keep trying, you will get there.
This does not happen a lot, but you have left me speechless. That was Kay, people. Another round of applause.
Well, it's a good thing I didn't leave when Reynolds started his nonsense. This kid can sing.
Oh, hi, Mr. Mackey. Didn't expect you here.
Yeah, it's good to see someone flourish. But I'd rather be home right now.
Isn't it fun to step out every once in a while?
Smoking a pipe and reading a proper book is the only acceptable way to spend a Sunday evening in September.
Bert, thank you so much for coming. I know you'd rather be somewhere else right now.
That's okay, kid. I don't regret it one bit. You did great. But ladies, if you'll excuse me, I'm out of here.
Good night, Bert. Thanks again.
And now for an announcement. I'm serious, so hush now. Now, you all know that Kay has been working here at the diner for quite a while now. In fact, she was my anchor after Stan left us. And I think the time has come to formally announce right here that I will put your name above the door of this place, honey, where it belongs. Kay's place. Mokays. We haven't settled on a name yet, but there you go. Another round of applause. And have some drinks with us.
How did it feel to be up there?
Oh, it was so great to be performing again. It felt amazing. I'm all over the place right now. It was such a rush. I will definitely be doing that again. If they let me, of course.
That was amazing.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much, Em. It felt amazing. I was so super nervous, you know? Like, shaking and all that. I'm so glad it went well.
I have to hand it to you. You were great. I have to go in a bit, but let me know when the next gig is, yeah?
You're not leaving already, are you? The fun's just starting. Oh, wait. Of course. Big day tomorrow, right? You know what you're going to do?
Honestly? Well...
Wait. I'm not good at this stuff, so I just want to say it was good to have you back these past weeks, Em. Really good. You just do what you feel you have to do. I'm just glad we reconnected. Promise you'll keep in touch? Whatever the outcome, yeah?
I'll do my best.
And remember, time marches on.
See you, Kay. Thanks. For everything.
My lovely people! The time has come for the open mic part of the evening to end. Ashley was going to do a ventriloquist bit next, but I just heard he hurt his hand back in his cabin. Let me thank you again for joining us, and there's plenty of food and drink to go around. I sure do hope they're keeping things proper in there while I'm taking a breather. So, you had fun?
Oh, it was great. Kay was amazing.
You said it. Oh, that girl is so talented. Oh, I'd give my big toe to be able to do what she does behind a keyboard. Oh, sheesh.
I had a great evening. Thanks, Maureen. I think I'm gonna go hit the hay. Early start.
Something on your mind, hon?
I don't know. I'm feeling a bit weird about tomorrow.
How did things end up with Kay? You could tell me to mind my own, of course. It's just that girl is like a daughter to me.
We talked, yeah. We really reconnected, and I'm happy we did.
Listen, you're two grown women, and if that's the choice you two ended up on, I can only respect that. Speaking of choices, you've got a big day in the morning, don't you? Know what you're gonna do yet? Stick around? Move back?
I think I have a feeling. Yeah.
Then you go follow that feeling, hon.
Thanks, Maureen.
I best get back inside. You take care now, Meredith Wise.
Take care, Maureen. Dear Meredith Wise, thank you for participating in our annual photography contest. Your wonderful picture did not win the grand prize, but you are still a winner. The attached voucher gives you a 20% discount to our autumn course. Sign up today and never take a blurry picture again. David Gillespie, Photography for Beginners, Inc.
Good morning, Meredith. You won't believe the weekend I had. Saturday, I placed a bet on the Angels, just like you said, and won. But they played again yesterday, and I let it ride, and then they lost. They're playing again tonight, and now I don't know what to do anymore.
Well, Frank, the pattern is obvious. And betting against the pattern pays off. White Sox.
Okay, Meredith, thanks. I'll go with that. Speaking of gambling, I bet you're taking the job. And that's not just because you're wearing your coat.
I love the coat, Frank. But no, I'm taking it off. I'm leaving Providence Oaks again.
Oh, that's not what I was hoping to hear, Meredith. But I understand. What are you gonna do?
Well, actually, I'm,
A van? So you're staying in the delivery business? No, wait. That's an RV.
Yep. I'm getting on it, and I'm not sure where I'll stop. So, I guess this is goodbye. I'm gonna miss you, Frank. Thanks for everything. Try to stay out of trouble, okay?
Don't worry, Meredith. I'll be fine. Thanks for everything. Take care and drive safe.
Here she is, the sea turtle in all of her glory. Do you like her?
I love her, Lori. She's amazing.
Yay! Hey, Meredith, I'm going to miss you.
I'll miss you too, Lori. It was really fun watching that movie and working on the RV with you.
Me too. Besides, you'll be back sometime, right?
Of course. I have to check on my favorite engineer.
You mean me? Ha! I'd love that. Safe travels, Meredith.
Thank you, Lori. See you around.
Guess who?
You know, I'm just gonna guess Jack Burton again.
It's me, Angie Eastman. You know, I thought it'd be easier to guess the second time around. So, this is the RV, huh?
Yeah. She may not look like much, but she'll get the job done.
It's perfect. So, where are we going first?
Yeah, about that.
Hmm?
I would really, seriously, definitely like you to go with me.
Wow. You've got me speechless. Again.
I've grown quite fond of you, Angie. Hadn't you noticed?
And here I was wondering if it was just my imagination. The feeling's mutual, babe.
So you probably have to go pack, right?
Well, there it is. It's not much, just some clothes, some toiletries and trinkets, and 7 shoeboxes filled with videotapes. So yeah, I'm all packed.
Is that everything you own?
Nah, all the big stuff is in storage right now. You know, furniture, electronics, life-size cardboard standee of Arnold Schwarzenegger as Colonel John Matrix, the usual. Anyway, give me the keys. I've heard about your driving.
What have you heard? From who?
People talk.
When advertising exec David Howard, parentheses Albert Brooks, is passed over for a promotion and subsequently fired, he decides to change his whole life. He convinces his wife Linda, parentheses Monica Johnson, to sell their house and roam the country, easy rider style, in a Winnebago. Okay, forget this one. That's just not going to be relatable at all.
Nope. We've got nothing in common with those guys. I have another flick where a bunch of academics set up a ghost hunting business in an old fire station. That should be way more accessible.
Angie Eastman, have you seen every single tape in here?
Not all of them, but most.
Come on.
But I don't mind watching them again. In fact, I'd love to see them with someone who
knows nothing about movies.
I was going to put it a little nicer than that. Someone who has unspoiled virgin eyes.
Virgin eyes? What are you, a poet now? All right, well, Lost in America will unspool before these virgin eyes soon enough. Tell me about Stand By Me. It's about 4 kids from Oregon, right?
Sharp a button in, folks. But I've got a special treat for y'all. I just updated my playlist. This new song is from our very own Kay Evans.
So, what have I missed?
Well, Matt Kearney's condition is worth a mention. But the final act is supposed to be the real showstopper. At least, that's what Maureen tells me.
Really? Well then, I guess I arrived just in time.
So, how've you been? Thanks for the note. It was very sweet.
I meant every word, babe. So, have you...
Hey, Meredith! Hey, Angie! Sorry to pop in like this, but I just wanted to inform you I fixed everything on the RV. She's got a new radio, I replaced some wiring, adjusted windshield wiper speed. The sea turtle is ready to go!
That's great, Lori. Thanks. I'm sure she's just like new.
Well, I wouldn't say that, but you'll see. Gotta go, later!
An RV? You never told me you had an RV.
Well, it's kind of a recent development. You know Mickey and June?
The hippie couple? Sure do.
They told me it was mine if I wanted it. And I did. Then Lori gave it a checkup. And now I am the proud owner of this sea turtle.
Wow, good for you. I'd love a free RV.
You know, come to think of it, you might have more of a use for it than I do.
I... I'd love an RV. I mean, that'd be perfect. But I don't know if I can accept it. I mean, June and Mickey must have entrusted you with it for a reason. Are you sure you don't want to keep it?
Nah, I'm good. It's all yours.
Wow, I don't know what to say. And that's a first for me.
Don't mention it. I just like seeing you happy.
And vice versa, babe, really. Come with me. I mean it. Leave this sad old town behind and go wherever we want to go. Free spirits, the way Mickey and June intended.
I have grown quite fond of you, you know.
Likewise, Miss Weiss. But at some point, you've got to give me a definite answer. You get that, right?
Dear Meredith Weiss, thank you for participating in our annual photography contest. Your wonderful picture did not win the grand prize, but you are still a winner. The attached voucher gives you a 20% discount to our autumn course. Sign up today and never take a blurry picture again. David Gillespie, Photography for Beginners, Inc.
Good morning, Meredith. You won't believe the weekend I had. Saturday, I placed a bet on the Angels, just like you said, and won. But they played again yesterday, and I let it ride, and then they lost. They're playing again tonight, and now I don't know what to do anymore.
Well, Frank, the pattern is obvious. So, the Angels will win this time.
Okay, Meredith, thanks. I'll go with that. Speaking of gambling, I bet you're taking the job. And that's not just because you're wearing your coat.
I love the coat, Frank. But no, I'm taking it off. I'm leaving Providence Oaks again.
Oh, that's not what I was hoping to hear, Meredith. But I understand. What are you going to do?
Back to my home, my job, and my life in the big city.
So I guess you're going back to the future, eh? Computers, living in the fast lane. Can't say that I envy you. Although it must be nice to live close to a major ballpark. Do you need a ride to the airport?
Yes, please. I'd love to take one last look over the lake.
All right, go grab your stuff and let's go.
And the V-belt is not in great shape, but it should last you another month or three. The sea turtle in all of her glory. Do you like her? Meredith and I named her.
She's pretty amazing, Lori. Cute name, too. Thanks for doing this for me.
You're very welcome. Hey, Meredith, I'm going to miss you.
I'll miss you too, Lori. It was really fun watching that movie and working on the RV with you.
Me too. Besides, you'll be back sometime, right?
Of course. I have to check on my favorite engineer.
You mean me? Ha! I'd love that. Safe travels, Meredith.
Thank you, Lori. See you around.
Magnificent, isn't she?
Yeah, she certainly knows a lot about cars for a kid her age.
I meant the RV. But sure, Lori's great too.
So, you all packed?
Sure am. The big stuff's in storage. But I've got the bare necessities. Clothes, toiletries, and a whole bunch of videotapes. So, where are we going first?
Yeah, about that. I think you should go alone.
Oh, yeah? Well, I disagree. I don't want to be alone, and I think you should go with me.
I'm sorry, Angie. It just doesn't feel right.
I mean, that makes sense. It makes a lot of sense, actually, even though it's not quite what I was expecting or hoping.
We'll keep in touch. We'll meet again. It's just that this is what I need to do right now.
I get it. It's okay. So, do I at least get a goodbye hug?
Of course. Come here.
Sure am gonna miss you, babe. Happy travels.
Did you catch a case of cold feet?
I guess that's what you could call it. Please take me to the airport, Frank.
So, here we are again, heading the other way. Aren't you going to miss it here?
Probably. It feels odd to be leaving again.
I wouldn't want to leave this place, not for $1 million. Well, wait, no, $2 million should be enough.
Do you believe money can buy happiness?
That's a good question. Give me a big pile of cash right now and I'll feel real happy. And I'm sure it'll last a couple of days, but then it'll probably start to wear off and I'll be back to complaining about the weather before you know it. But it's probably nicer to complain about the weather when you're living in a big old mansion. Hey, what's this honking clown up to? Move out of the way, you lunatic! Wait a minute. That's Robert Harris. Yeah, I'm pulling over.
Sorry about that, Frank. Hope it didn't scare you.
That's okay, Robert. I'm a road rage veteran. But, what's all this about?
It's not about you, Frank. I need to talk to Meredith.
Oh, okay. I'll go have a smoke.
Hey, Meredith. This is gonna sound super awkward. And hopeless. And desperate. And probably a lot more things, but I don't want you to leave. I've decided a while ago that I'm done with stuff like this, but I guess it's not something you can decide.
Robert, that's so sweet of you, but I've made up my mind about this. I'm leaving P.O.
Yeah, okay, yeah. I sort of kind of figured you'd say that.
Well, I don't know what to say to you now.
I guess there's nothing left to say. I better get back to work again. Take care.
Thanks, Robert. And let me know if the apartment troubles start again.
Okay, Meredith. Let's get you to the airport. I've got a double shift today, and the mail doesn't deliver itself.
Sharper button in, folks, but I've got a special treat for y'all. I just updated my playlist. This new song is from our very own Kay Evans.
Dear Meredith Weiss, thank you for participating in our annual photography contest. Your wonderful picture did not win the grand prize, but you are still a winner. The attached voucher gives you a 20% discount to our autumn course. Sign up today and never take a blurry picture again. David Gillespie, Photography for Beginners, Inc.
Good morning, Meredith. You won't believe the weekend I had. Saturday, I placed a bet on the Angels, just like you said, and won. But they played again yesterday, and I let it ride, and then they lost. They're playing again tonight, and now I don't know what to do anymore.
Well, Frank, the pattern is obvious. And betting against the pattern pays off, White Sox.
Okay, Meredith, thanks. I'll go with that. Speaking of gambling, I bet you're taking the job, and that's not just because you're wearing your coat.
I love the coat, Frank. And yes, I want to wear it a bit longer.
Fantastic. So you'll be delivering the mail today? I'll give HR a call and tell them the vacancy is filled.
Not so fast, Frank. It's under one condition. If you get in a predicament with Walter Morgan again, you're on your own.
Ha, you got it. I'll have Morgan for breakfast. Now, let's get to work. The mail doesn't deliver itself.
Okay, let's see what today's weather will be like.
P
P.O. people, good morning. Today's weather will be nothing short of gorgeous, and I can't wait to go outside and head out to the acres. But not before sharing, you know what?
P.O. positive or pet peeves?
I don't need callers for today's P.O. positive. I'm picking it myself. I'm talking about Moe's open mic last night. I hope y'all enjoyed it as much as I did. And I'm sorry if I offended anyone with my jokes. Well, no, actually, I am not sorry. Not sorry at all. Thank you much, Mo and Kay, for hosting it. It's just one of the things that makes Providence Oaks the best place in the world. Have a great day.
You tell him, Jack. What's this guy up to? Wait, is that Robert? Yeah, Robert, I'll pull over.
Hey, Meredith, sorry about that. I hope it didn't scare you.
Hey, Robert, what's going on?
Well, this is going to sound super awkward and hopeless and desperate and probably a lot more things, but I don't want you to leave. I've decided a while ago that I'm done with stuff like this, but I guess it's not something you can decide.
Robert, that's so sweet of you, but I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, I figured you'd say that. Wait, what? You're not going?
Yep. It's nice here.
Oh, wow. Okay, great. Well, I might as well blurt it all out. I like you. A lot. I didn't want to give in to it. I've been through a rough breakup once, and I didn't want to risk ever feeling like that again.
So, what do you propose? That I just get in your car right now?
I wasn't gonna propose, but yeah, Meredith. I'd love that.
Okay.
Coffee at Moe's?
And a piece of pie.
Sharper button in, folks, but I've got a special treat for y'all. I just updated my playlist. This new song is from our very own Kay Evans.
So many places left Bye.